Yeah, I think that's great. Michael, of course you'll be over there. Unless you have somewhere to be. Linger in this area. Just kind of linger. Okay, you got everything you're going to grab. Are you going to grab the Red Wolf?
Right here. It has one. Oh,
got it. Yes, got it.
How long are we spending on each gun? What do you want? No details.
Just grab. It's going to be about 15 minutes, whole thing.
Okay.
Just grab it. We're going to grab and go.
All right, just start asking questions. I'll answer it.
Got it. Right now?
Yes.
Oh, hey, what's up? Ha! That's why you gotta love live, because it happens whenever you're not ready.
That's right.
All right, so we are here. We found the British Pavilion. This is a section where if you're an air gunner, you've got to get to, because you're gonna see some of the greatest products coming out of here. I'm here with Shane from Daystate, and he is gonna kind of run us through some of the new Daystate products. But I mean, behind me, you've got there's Brocock here. We've got the MTC Brocock optics here. There's a little bit of everything.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, bud?
Good. Good to see you.
Say hi to all the airheads out there.
How you guys doing? Thanks for watching.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
Don't you love going live?
You know,
we did this last year.
Yeah, always put me on the spot. That's okay.
Exactly.
You're good at it.
Shane loves to talk, hates to talk, but he's really good at it. Look at him. He's got. I mean, gorgeous young man.
You got the beard going and everything.
You starting to get the gray.
I know. Three little girls.
Watch out. Exactly. All right. Enough about us. Let's talk air guns. What am I looking at? It's the Daystate world. Talk to me.
Yeah, so what we got is right here on the front pedestal.
Pick one, let's talk about it.
Start from the top and go to the bottom.
Now this is, can I get this out of here?
There you go. This is the Brocock Commander Cerakote Edition.
Now this is a very, very tactical.
It is.
But this foldable is all AR.
Stock, foldable stock, AR 15 adjustable butt stock. You can put whatever, you know, your favorite AR backstock on it.
Really?
AK-47 grip. Has the trigger guard, so it's replaceable. Picatinny rail, tops and bottom. So it's just a real tactical, beefy looking.
Oh gosh, this is a beefy looking gun. It looks like I'm going to say it can sound like an idiot, but it looks like a sniper rifle.
It is.
And I think it comes from the sniper rifle line, right?
It shoots like one as well.
So anything AR, anything,
yes,
AK, anything hand, you can,
interchange
any parts,
make it however you want.
Really?
Which is nice. You know, it gives an end user the convenience of kind of customizing the gun to make it the way they like it.
Okay.
So I've seen all kinds of stuff put on these.
What's happening here?
So we got obviously two gauges. It's a regulated gun. So you got the air pressure, which is in the tank.
Okay.
And then the Huma regs, which will show your air pressure. Fully adjustable right there on the bottom of the gun.
Okay.
Take an Allen wrench. You can adjust the regulator to whatever pressure you want. So if you want more power, great. If you want less power, higher shot count, you can do that as well. Full free floating hammer with adjustable with a 5mm hex wrench. So you can really fine tune this gun. So if you're a guy wanting, you know, for example, in the Magnum, this is the standard version, also available in Magnum version.
Okay.
If you want a 22 doing 55 foot-pounds of energy, you can do that. If you want to back that down to 30 foot-pounds of energy, shoot some 18 grain JSBs,
yeah,
get a higher shot count, you can do that as well.
So oh, wow.
Very versatile.
And you can adjust the power here?
Correct. So this is your valve restriction. I believe there's 5 power levels on it. Single shot tray, which is in the gun. 10 shot rotary magazine. And you know, one thing I guess people ask, they're concerned with the bullet. Hey, this, it looks like it might be hard to cock. I mean, go ahead and cock that gun. That simple. So everybody that I've ever showed the gun to,
yeah,
and I've sat down and shot it, they're like, man, I can just sit and
rack this. Because it's got this smaller little hammer area here.
It's a
free-floating
hammer, so it's a spring that you don't have to really pull back hard on.
So you can literally adjust every single part of this gun.
Correct.
Yes. And make it anything you want power-wise.
Yeah. You can kind of, like I said, fine-tune it to your needs.
And you can change the rear, and you can change the handle, and you can change the trigger.
Yeah, the trigger guard. Yeah, I've seen guys put the big, you know, loop trigger guard on.
Yeah.
Kind of make it real tactical. Or if you got larger fingers and your finger rubs up against the bottom, you can,
yeah,
you know,
widen it out.
That. Correct.
Wow.
Two stage fully adjustable trigger.
Is this, I'm guessing this is just on here because it just makes it look more,
yeah,
awesome?
And it's a real popular bipod that we sell a lot of, is the AccuTax.
Okay. Wow. Brocock Commander. Right out of the gate.
So this is
awesome.
Cerakote version, also available in black. So if,
okay,
you're a Cerakote fan and, you know, you just want something all black, available in black as
is
well.
Is this six?
I believe so.
Yeah, wow. So yeah. Very, very AR.
Correct. Yeah, it's
I mean, Shane, where do you go from here? This thing's awesome.
It's one of my favorites. Actually, just picked one up in 1 second.
Feet per second?
Well, again, depending where you want to set up. In 22,
oh, sure, because you're
30 foot-pounds, 25, 45 foot-pounds, 177, 20. That's on the standard gun, which we're holding here. The Magnum, which we'll look at a little bit.
There's a Magnum. So we're talking, so 177 up to 25?
Correct. And in the Magnums, you're talking 22, 55 foot-pounds of energy, 25 cal, 60 foot-pounds of energy. And then obviously adjustable up and down.
This is, I'm not going to lie, this is complex for the average air gunner. I mean, there's a lot. Like, this is, you got to study this gun to really know how to work it. If you're new,
you know, it's nice. You don't have to do that. But if you're a guy that wants to, it's capable of doing it.
I'm gonna get it, send it back to Shane. Shane's gonna make it what I want, send it back to me, and then I'll have exactly how I want it.
With a bill.
But you know what I'm gonna do? More power. Because I'm an idiot.
Power.
Yeah. All right.
It's the American way. More power, the better.
It
right?
is the American way. This side or this side?
Yeah,
there we
like
go.
That.
Okay. So that's an awesome gun.
Yeah.
Check. One gun. Awesome. One down. All right. What's next?
All right. So this is the Pulsar. It's a Daystate Pulsar. It's called the Saxon. This gun's been around for a couple of years.
The Pulsar's been around.
It has.
Okay.
They
digital.
Basically just changed up the stock, put a different color laminate on it. And it's going to be a limited run, and they're going to do a few other guns that are limited. And just kind of sexied up the gun with the a little bit nicer stock on
it. So this is just a different color?
Yes.
Okay.
Correct. And it has, if you're familiar with the Pulsar, it has electronic systems, so very consistent valve. Same electronic system that you're going to find in the Red Wolf.
Okay. And I've reviewed this gun, and I'll be honest, did not show it its full capabilities because, I'm impatient and not the most steady of shooter for paper, but that's my own cross to bear, and you guys don't have to worry about that because this gun can do and be everything and anything you want it to be.
Correct. It has three programming levels, high, medium, and low, so you can go from high power, medium, and low within a couple seconds.
Again, so much adjustment.
A lot of technology built in this gun.
Wow. Killer. All right.
Put that right in there.
Got it. What's next?
So then we got the new Brocock Sniper with the laminate stock. So the Sniper's been around for about a year now.
Okay.
Same action as the Commander that we just talked about.
Right.
But obviously not with all the AR, AK, parts on it. A little bit more traditional stock.
I mean, traditionals, yeah, I think might be the wrong word.
You're right. But that would be the Regal back there. That's traditional.
More typical than what were some of the stuff we've seen from Brocock and Daystate before.
This is more of a hybrid, I guess.
Yeah.
It's technically a bullpup.
Is it a bullpup?
That's why it's a hybrid. The trigger's a little bit forward of the action.
Okay,
much,
right.
But you still have plenty of room to get your cheek on.
Sure.
And, cock the gun without any issues. Still has the power adjuster, regulators, like we talked about.
Wow.
Rails,
oh man, it's amazing, like the balance. Though, like with a gun like this, like it's still very, it still just feels very balanced. Even though it's small and it's shorter, it still feels that center balance is pretty incredible.
Very well. It's very deceiving. It looks like a real heavy gun.
Yeah, and it's not at all.
When you shoulder and pick it up, it's not heavy.
So still tank inside internal. You can
all
still adjust this. You can still adjust
the commander. Correct.
Man.
The laminate stock is new. I mean, we got three of these in. Got another shipment in about a month here in the United States.
This is actually fairly light. Like this is a pretty light gun.
Yeah, I mean, like I said,
especially for some of the competitors.
And they hold it. It's like, that's actually really light.
Wow, killer.
Yeah.
No, so then what? 22?
177, 22, 25.
All of 25.
Again, also in the Magnums.
Oh, and there's a Magnum version of this too.
Correct. You can interchange the stock with all the actions, which is real convenient.
Yep. There we go. It's a science just to get these guns back where they belong. Okay.
Yeah.
So is everything in a Magnum now?
Just about. With a lot of the competitions that have been out there and the extreme bench rests, guys looking for the edge. And it seems like if you're not at a certain foot-pounds of level, it's tough.
All right, what's next?
So this gun's been around for about 6 months now, but never ever really been showed. It's the Daystate Red Wolf, which a lot of people are familiar with. The walnut stock, awesome.
All right, so what you're probably used to, though, is the Red Wolf is red.
The laminate, yeah.
The laminate, crazy red laminate stock that's over there. So this is the Red Wolf, but it's just with a wood stock.
Correct.
Okay, the walnut stock,
personally,
nice.
Personally, I love the Ferrari look and the red.
Yeah.
But there are guys that just want the walnut.
Okay,
the wood guys,
fair enough.
So, basically the same gun as the Red Wolf, but it's a 24-inch. It's an HP version, the Magnum version.
Okay.
So, Extreme Bench Press last year is the gun I shot, and A lot of other people like Michael went who did real well.
Yeah.
And we're shooting 22 calibers at 55 foot-pounds of energy.
Yeah.
And, you know, the BC on that pellet's a little bit higher than some of the 25 or 30 cal. And, you know, we're getting half-inch groups at 100 yards.
Half-inch groups at 100 yards.
Yeah, obviously it's tough to do, but it is capable of doing it.
You're right. I mean, not everybody, to be very clear, not everybody can get half-inch groups at 100 yards. The gun's capable of it,
but you still got to be good. Yeah. But the gun is capable, and then obviously it's up to you.
Up to the shooter. Sure.
But, you know, I've had guys at the range that never shot an air rifle, 22 guys, and I let them shoot the Red Wolf, and they're putting inch and a half groups at 100 yards for the first time they ever shot an air gun.
Which is still not bad.
Oh, he was amazing. That's
fantastic.
I shoot my 22 rimfire.
Right.
So, I mean, he's like, I got to get one of these.
Okay, so this is the HP. What makes this HP?
So the standard Red Wolf is a 17-inch barrel.
Okay.
This has a 24-inch barrel in it.
Okay, so how much increase in power or distance or action do you get? What is
on the 22, you're about 35 to 38 foot-pounds maxed out.
Okay.
This one just maxed out about 55 foot-pounds of energy.
Oh, wow, so you're getting it's quite a bit.
Correct,
it's like 17 more
foot-pounds. Yeah, you're pushing the 25.
That's a whole other gun.
Yeah, you're pushing 25-grain JSB redesigns.
Yeah.
You know, 960, 980 FPS.
Ah, wow. Wow, all right.
It's moving. So yeah, it's
I mean, the walnut's nice, but...
No, the laminate's the way to go.
The Ferrari's the Ferrari.
Red, right?
What are you going to do?
That's right.
I like to call it Razorback Red, but that's just, you know, that's my own, that's my own personally. All right, so...
I said that right there.
Is that it?
Oh, we got a couple new Brocock guns. Actually, Claudio Flores won Extreme Adventurist.
Yeah, I saw him. Can we, like, this is, guys, again, right, this is here. The beauty. This is the beauty of, so, like, you just literally, you walk over here and, like, ba-bow.
Claudio, get over here.
You've got Lauren. You can see Lauren Parsons. Bam. Ladies, world championship. World champion. Second, world championship right there. Michael Wendt, right there. Look at him. He's a sexy guy, made for camera. 2018 EBR won three competitions.
Three gold medals.
Claudio Flores, the champion, EBR 2018 champion. Champion. I love it. Guys, how we doing?
It's really cool here.
Yeah?
Love it.
Yeah? First time? Not first time here.
First time in
first
Vegas.
Timer? First time in Vegas?
Yes.
Oh, you're going to make bad decisions. Don't do it.
You're in trouble.
Don't do it.
My fourth day here, it's already
back. Okay, good. Well, Vegas will get you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Claudio, how are you, sir? Good?
Very good. Hi, guys. My name is Claudio Flores from Chile. This is my first shot show. I am very happy for coming in here.
Yeah, are you?
My English is not good. ¿Cómo están, amigo?
What?
Claudio Flores.
Yeah, there you go.
The Spanish is better.
Better. For the Spanish audience, go.
Yeah. ¿Cómo están, amigos? Mi nombre es Claudio Flores. Estoy feliz de estar acá en el Shot Show de Las Vegas en el 2019. Quiero presentarles lo nuevo de Brocock. Este es el prototipo del Patagonia Brocock. Lo nuevo que va a salir está firmado por mí. Este es my signature.
This is what I'm talking about. This is great. So you gotta take me through this. Tell me about it. I mean, obviously, I love that champions are just hanging out here in the Daystate Brocock booth. Just like, hey, what's up, Circle Champions? Just hanging out. I love it. It's good stuff, Michael. Appreciate it, man. Of course, you guys know Michael from Airgun Nation. One of our partners here at American Airgunner this season. So excited about that. If there's anything you want to talk airgun, Airgun Nation is the place to go, as you know. And then this young lady you're going to see more of because she's this new world champion shooter. She's around. We followed her at EBR, did a fun story on her. All that's coming up on this upcoming season of American Airgunner. And then you're going to see this man dominate at EBR and win the 2018 championship. So I might understand because mi español muy poquito español. Yeah. Which that's really the other than El Gato Los Pantalones Tango El Gato Los Pantalones.
No.
I've got a big cat in my pants. It's not your thing. Just saying, I know minimal Spanish. So are you trying to tell me this is your signature gun that you won the competition with?
This is same barrel, rota barrel.
Same, the actual gun, or is this a new? Talk to me, Shane. Is this like?
It's not the actual gun.
Hold on, you gotta talk to the people. Like you got your back to air gunners.
Yeah.
Come over here with me. I want you to stare at.
Yeah, so if you see the picture right here, I was taking an extreme bench rest. That's his personal gun that he was using. And Claudio does his own cerakoting and does a lot of stuff back in Patagonia.
So you made, you took the Brocock. Yeah. What Brocock? What?
Sniper.
So well, you took the sniper, made this, and now you guys have replicated it.
Correct. We got the cerakote stock, the shroud. It's the high power Magnum version, 22 caliber. Also going to be available in 25. Yeah, 55 foot pounds of energy.
So yeah, I mean you developed this gun. Champion and engineer, unbelievable! And see, that's why you got Patagonia Airguns. Like you got like this guy's doing stuff. That's why we got to have him on American Airgun or more, so we can learn the stuff that you're doing. Because this is amazing. No, so is this Brocock now selling this gun that you essentially built?
Yes, this is the final version. I mean, this will obviously be different. But this is we just got this here in SHOT Show. Delivered.
Actually. What's the bit? What are the? Give me. What are the main differences from the regular rifle that he changed to make this version?
Well, before the Magnums were out, there was only a couple Magnums in existence. One with Claudio and a couple out there where guys were making themselves.
Right.
And you know, with the performances that he was getting and the feedback he was giving us, it was a simple switch. You know, it was a phone call to Daystate Brocock and said, hey. Start throwing the 24-inch barrels in these guns, and we'll tune them a little bit differently, and we'll be able to achieve those foot-pounds.
Wow.
And, you know, after what he did at Extreme Bench Press, and
22
caliber, never been done.
Yeah.
He's been getting a lot of demand for them. And you can get this gun with, you know, the standard all-black, but why would you want that when you can get the champion gun,
The champion gun.
Yeah, 22 caliber, first 22 caliber win in EVR.
Right, because it's always been a higher caliber, right? 30's been the main caliber for the past.
And 30 caliber.
Yeah.
22 is crazy.
Now, do you remind him consistently that you kicked his ass? Yeah, I thought so. I thought he might.
You got about 10 months. 10 months of that. Me and Michael are coming for you.
So this is what this is all setting up for. EBR 2019. This guy and this guy and probably Lauren. We're gonna get her. She did a best, you know, like similar at EBR, but new, right? New shooters, just learning. And Michael Wendt are going to be. There's gonna be a battle, and we're gonna be there to cover it.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be awesome because Michael came out of nowhere, wins 3 golds, right? Now you got a target on your back.
Oh, yeah, he does.
Defend it now.
Let the trash talk begin. All right, that is it from the Daystate booth right here, guys. Thanks for checking in. Of course, this is the beauty of SHOT Show. You get to meet some of the champions you've seen at competitions, meet some of the people you see, whether it's Airgun Nation or any of the Daystate Brocock, all the guns, all the players, Patagonia Airguns, and of course, American Airgunner. We're all here hanging out, which is great. So that's it. We're going to be live. Probably at MTC right over there in like 5 minutes. So hang out. We're going to find out what's new in the optical world. See what MTC Optics has got to bring us this year. Later. Guys,
see you guys.
Appreciate it.